Welcome back, fellow scrubs. Mark D. Wiz. We got Pocket Fighter EX because it's Monday, which is a community-based game. It's not affiliated with Capcom or SNK. It's non-profit. It's free. There's a link for the demo out down below. You want to check that out? All that stuff. So, got that out of the way. We're going to continue on what we were doing last time and trying to get this stage up to par. Hey, Blackheart, what's up? I see you're back. Thanks for coming back. We've got one move test I'd like to try out before we do that. It's just something I was thinking about in the latter half of the day today. And what I wanted to try was to use the third crazy kick as a, like, this will work here because that's using a max cancel. But what if you could take someone out of the air like that, like say in this situation? Just kind of made me think, because you can use, let's try this again. There we go. You can use this. And that's good for when you're farther in the stage. If I could do it right the other way. Oh, I gotta practice this thing on pad. There we go. So see, pushes them away. It's pretty cool. And you can use it in the corner. Little easier. Hey, what's up? There you go. I was gonna hit it here, but you can do the kicks there, and then you can do that. You're in Russian. It's 3 a.m. Holy crap, get some sleep. What are you doing here? I'm happy to have you. I'm playing Vorit at the minute. Wanted to say hi. I'll be back in like an hour or something. I don't know what. Valorant. I don't know what Valorant is. Must be a game, of course. Yeah, I don't know, man. What are you doing up? You don't know. Well, that's fine. Come, ye lost children, at the 3 a.m. hour. I'll entertain you for a while. So the idea I was thinking of is if you could do... Oh. Yeah. Alright, if you could do that and then... Well, I am off the mark today. And then you could do that at the end. That would be kind of cool, right? So I'd like to experiment a little bit before we get into the stage pixel art stuff. Just to see what would happen if we did that. And this is sometimes the stuff that I do behind the scenes. I'm not really sure. I just kind of come up with an idea of, yeah, maybe that would work or maybe it won't. So that is Special Kick EX. And what we would need to do in order to make that work is the way that hits work would juggle. Like that. So you can do that. That'll follow up. So how come that follows up? But this doesn't follow up. It's because the Shoryuken can take advantage of a juggle situation. And the Special Kick EX cannot. At least not right now. So we do the hit here. This is the attack data on the bottom. And what I will want to change it to is... Let's see... Here, can juggle, can post juggle, force juggle. I can't hit off the ground. These are the juggling switches here. So if I say can juggle, then that should now be possible. If I can do it. Yeah, just like that. How about that? And then you can go ahead and do a follow-up. The question becomes is... How does this work in the corner? could you be able to follow it up with anything? And I don't think it sets a juggle flag. Okay, Cat says it's authentically here. I'd go get some tea. Not sure I understand what you mean, but I'm happy to ask for an elaboration. I'd like to understand. I think communication is a very big thing that a lot of people don't do anymore. They think they want to communicate. I think most people just want to talk. I don't actually want to listen and understand. Of course, that makes me ask a question 5 times. I don't get it. Can you say it again? Or I didn't hear it. I don't understand. What is it? And then I sound like an idiot, but I'd rather understand. Let's see. There should be things that can set a juggle. Now, I probably don't want to set a juggle. Where are... Man, there's so many settings now per attack here that it's... I get lost in all the stuff that I've built into this engine. Is launch, you think? I don't think that. No, that's for like ground bounce, land bounce. Or, sorry, not ground bounce. Or, yeah, land bounce is when you fall. Oh, hey! Hey, thanks for the follow! Hey, your name's Mark 2. I just realized that. You're M Mark 52. Reminds me of an old NES game called B52 that was pretty good. At least I liked it. I got the C, though. You got the K. A lot of people don't realize that, and they keep spelling my name with a K. Not so much on the internet, but at work. Thank you. Oh my god, where is the juggle settings? I think I made it a drop down somewhere here. Oh, here. I breezed right past it the entire time. So, if they're in the air, then you can set the juggle. Oh, it's copying from the other one, so. All right, this is gonna be super busted, but I just wanted to see what it would look like. Oh, we gotta get him closer to the corner. Or do we? I wonder if you could, we'll see, hold on. Nah, it's too, I think there's not enough time to get out of it. We show frame inputs. Or not frame inputs, but... Yeah, I think it's too slow. I don't think you could get a follow-up even if you wanted to. I was thinking like this. Oh, wait, hold on. I didn't do this after. They'd have to be a lot higher to do something like that. The Power Max version is different. So if we want to actually see what that looks like, we're gonna have to do something like this. We gotta set it. They're actually two different moves. Yeah, so in that case, that one has that, the Power Max version. You'll notice that it goes farther than that one does. I think it's got a little more air time. So you can do stuff with it that you can't otherwise with the other one. I think it has a bigger hitbox too. But if I do... This one's hard in the corner. And that one's really hard in the corner. To get this, and then also this. Yes, English is very interesting. It's also not very good. There's a lot of rules in English that make it very difficult to learn, I think. When you really think about it. invested on. Too low. Yes! Hello! Yes, I'm making this. Hey, hey, thanks for the follow! Let's see. I'm gonna try to pronounce this. Pre-go-red. Pre-go-red? 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 I'm sorry. I can't pronounce anything. But thanks for the follow. Pre-go-red. Okay, got it. Got it. Yeah, as of gore. Well, gore is a verb. Wait, I know, is it? Gore is a noun, right?
Oh, it's a noun and a verb.
It's like, a noun and a verb.
Oh, there's so much gore and viscera, or it's like, oh, the bull gored that guy.
Yeah, gored. So gored. Yeah, yeah, so it would be a verb. Gored would be a verb. Yeah, that's what I thought. So, hey, you're good. This actually, if this exists, even without the juggle, actually allows you to follow up a little better. Oh. Yeah, screw it up. My hands are just not working right today.
Somebody's getting followed.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Thanks, internet randos.
What engine is this? I'm new to coding, been coding since quarantine. Hey, that's a good time to start, right? So I'm working in the Unity engine. And then I built my fighting game engine inside of that. So Unity's not bad. It's good for, like, starters. It's not the most optimized thing. It's got its own quirks. But it's not bad. Like, if you were a AAA studio and you needed to every possible optimization, let's put it. Like, you want every frame... You want every frames per second squeezed out of the thing, you're probably going to use something like Unreal. You need like high fidelity, state-of-the-art 3D graphics. Unreal is your go-to. But if you don't need all that, then Unity's pretty much what I would recommend. I think it's got that nice, it's a little easier to learn, because you're not using C++, you're using C#. I don't know much about Godot. I've heard a couple people using it here and there. I can't make formulated opinion because I've never used it, and I don't know anybody who's really used it to the degree that would help me understand.
Stop eating up my Habanero cherry.
Yeah, sorry.
No, you're not. You're jealous.
I am not jealous.
You've been my Habanero since I was 9.
I know.
Well, I just have to ask John Cena DLC when.
Wouldn't that be amazing? We'd get sued into oblivion, but it would be amazing. It would be amazing. And it's good. Yeah, Python's pretty easy to use. It's very unoptimized, though, so I wouldn't make a game with it. But yeah, so if Godot's kind of like the ease of use of Python with game optimization, that sounds neat. I don't know. I don't know enough about it to say either way. From personal experience. But hey, part of the whole debate is like, hey, if it works for you, then cool, man. If it works for you, that's great. I'm trying to think now. Nah, you're not gonna get anything off of that. I think you can. Yeah, you can do that. Oh, I didn't have enough for a super. You could do that. So, since that already exists, I'm not worried too much about this causing another loop. Oh, man. It's a hard cancel to get. There we go. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's enough time for it anyway. So, the other concern I would have when adding a move like this would be, what's the difference? Oh, man. What's the difference in damage? So this at base value does 70. And then the other ender we know of, 80. That actually does more. Let's see. That does 70. This does 65. Oh. Here we go. So that does 270. 271. And that does 279. How long have I been coding? I don't do it necessarily for a living, so taking that into account, it's more or less spare time coding. Let's see, 2005 or 6 I started. So that's what. And then 2016 would be about 10 years. Plus 3 years. So 13 years-ish. 13, 14. For a period of time, I did do 2 commercial games. And I did program those. Along with a friend. So that I had full-time programming experience on. Those 2 projects. That was Hamster Drop and Ector Rush, which are no longer available. Thanks, publishers. Other than that, and then those are, we didn't make enough money to survive making games, so we had to disband. And that was 2014? Yeah, 2014. That went from 2013, from the start of 2012 to... Was it start of 2012? No, that was Christmas of 2012 I got laid off. So that would be 2013, the entire 2013 and the entirety of 2014 up until like November of 2014. Then I was kind of like full-time programmer and like project manager and designer and all that stuff. Basically the head of the project, but also doing other things. So that was the most fun I've ever had in my life. But all good things must come to an end, and so I'm back in the day job circuit. Once you learn the concepts, the actual words that you have to put down, the syntax as they call it, in order to make the statements work, and the programming is sort of arbitrary. It's really learning the concepts, and then those concepts can translate to other languages, and you don't have to worry about it so much. So jumping from... What was my first... I guess my first real programming language was C++, and then moving from C++ to C# was not that big of a transition. So let's see... Mark52 says, I'm trying to study Java on Java Rush. It's friendly... and funny, but I don't think people must cry when they're doing hard tasks. I'm pretty emotional, though. Well, hang in there. It's, Java is very much like a C++, just slightly different. So, like, Java is a less optimized programming language, but it works on almost everything. It's what they call an interpretive language, which means that it doesn't actually compile the code, it runs the code and interprets it on the fly, which makes it slower. It also makes it a little easier to run in other platforms. So it like kind of runs its own in its own little shell, so to speak, and then it can run basically anywhere. So that one's, it's not too much more friendly than C++, but It's a good starter language, if you want to put it that way. So, yeah, hang in there. All programming is really weird and tough when you first start doing it, but once you get the hang of it, you're like, oh, yeah. You gotta kind of, like, think in programming. You gotta think in how the numbers work and all that. And every time you think you know, oh, yeah, I know, like, probably 90% of this, you don't. There's always something new to learn with programming. No, sort of can be frustrating, but it also makes it interesting in that way. So just hang in there. I kind of like having that as an ender. I'm trying to think of what other things Ken can't do too much to launch the opponent. I'm trying to think if it's anything that's actually dangerous to leave this on by. Because you want to make sure like infinites and stuff don't occur when you add moves. But you want moves to be useful too. So I think the only problem here that I have with this move is the fact that this is 70 damage and this is 80 damage. And arguably, that's not as useful. So this is more useful because if you're close enough, you can get follow-ups. Where I don't think that's true. Oh, let's get a little closer. I'm gonna have to get the stick here in a second, because this is ridiculous. Oh, whoa! Screw that, you can get some kind of follow-up. Let's see. Pregord says, I'm preparing and building an asset library for Game Jam. That's the 29th. Oh, that's cool. Those are exciting. I've never done one, though. I don't think I do too well in one. I really don't. I think I'd want to get too detailed with it and run out of time, and then I would never finish it. So I've never really bothered to do it. I spend all my time doing stuff for this anyway. Alright, there's a link. We'll copy it. We'll copy it and put it in a separate window. Not gonna open it right here. I learned my lesson on that. No Twitter on screen. And no other- Oh, that's interesting. Okay, yeah, we can show that. So it's like a little platforming night adventure. Oh, you got them platforms and everything. Well, that's nifty. That's cool, yeah. I like that. The thin platforms are not necessarily all that easy. If you're doing your own platforming engine, at least. A lot of people get hung up on those. Oh, yeah. Yeah, let's put that in the Discord. If you want to join the Discord channel, too, there's the link there in chat. Tim, let me tag you on that. So I put it in the showcase. Let's see, from the live stream, a viewer project. There we go. So yeah, I'll put it in there. So yeah, it kind of seems like you'd have to if you don't do a super jump. Gotta get in a different mindset. Usually you want to do the super jump, but if you don't do the super jump, looks like you're going. I know you can get all three. It's a timing thing. Looks like when I did not do a super jump and I got all three kicks in, then I was able to follow it up. I'm not so much worried about the max cancel, I think. No, actually, I have to be worried about that. So, a max cancel doesn't let you do much there. So say if you're like out in the boonies, you could get that. Not in the boonies. So if you're out and you've got a lot of screen left to get them to the corner, then I think that this gives you more of an ability to follow up because they don't go quite as far. So that's the thought process I got now. How? To see, you can't even follow up with another attack. Other than this, is there really anything that's fast enough to reach? Maybe in the X Hadouken, but that doesn't. There's not much to glean there. Yeah, you can't even get that. Yeah, boonies. Yeah, so you don't know the slang. You just said that, like, the slang in English is weird. The boonies. You don't know what the boonies means then. So the boonies is like when you're out in the wilderness, like you live out in the country with all the trees and there's probably farm animals and there's not a lot of people around. That's the boonies. Like just out in the wilderness. You know, the people that live way out away from the cities. They live in the boonies. That's what we call the boonies. There's your American slang lesson today. So my current thought is this actually might be a dangerous move to have. Not necessarily that it causes an infinite or anything like that, but the fact that, I didn't think of that, hold on. The fact that you can also follow up. Oh, I was trying to run and then do this again. I thought that would be funny. This probably wouldn't be too much you could do off of that, but it would be kind of funny to do two of them. So, the problem here I have is that previously the only thing you could follow up with was that, or Shoryuken. That one's harder. Well, now you... I guess you could... Hold on. I'm gonna eat my words here. Yeah, you can do it with a Shoryuken anyway. Now, let's see. A Shoryuken is 80. And this is 70. Okay. Well, see, my concern here was that I thought maybe the only follow-up is this anyway. And if that's the case, this combo kind of has a specific use where it's only really good to use when you're near the corner, because that's where you're going to be able to follow up. Or if you get really desperate and you want to max cancel this and do this, then you could get that little bit of a follow up in the hard knockdown. So not too opposed to that. My real concern would be, hey, you know, we've got two combo paths here. So it's like, oh, you don't have to use any meter to get a follow-up that's not this. So a follow-up that gives you more options. Because again, when you follow up with this, that's pretty much it. There's not much you can do there. Even if you max cancel, there's not much you can do there. But if you were to... Oh, I can't do it. I'm so not used to doing that. So, if you get that and you follow up, I didn't do anything intelligent there. But if you did happen to follow up after that, then it's like, oh, well, you can then follow up by doing that. and you can actually do something off of that because you're not getting knocked away that far. But it's like, yeah, that's not a concern though, because if you time it right, you can get a Shoryuken anyway to do the same exact thing for better damage nonetheless. If I can time it right. What? What are you barking at? The dog's getting freaked out because another dog's barking and whining and... Sorry, I missed a couple messages there. Let's see, how far along into the game's development are you? Well, we've got 3 of the first 9 characters. So the first wave... My initial goal is 9 characters. If I can get to 9 characters, cool, then we can think about adding more. And my battery died in my controller. But you know what that means? That's an excuse. That's a sign from above that we need to use the stick, right? So let's do that. Might be easier to test. Watch, I say that, and I'm so off kilter that I'm gonna screw this up too. So if you want to think of in percentages that we have 3 characters and we have 9 total. Ugh, can't even do it here. Oh no, come on. Oh my god, come on. Really? There we go. Nah, he was too well. We want to think of it as that, then you could say that I'm like about 30% through. But we're trying to do online play and all this other stuff too. So maybe 25% might be, there we go, there's something. 25% might be more of a real estimate. Yeah, I don't think... Trying to get the Shoryuken canceled. I gotta wait. Oh. Gotta get all 3. It's hard. The Shoryuken cancel is hard. So, if I keep this, it's gonna have to be... Well, it does less damage, for one. And it gives you less options to follow up with, so... Maybe it's alright, it's kind of like an intermediary option. I just don't know if it really needs to exist. Because the only other thing that it can do the only other thing that can do that is the Shoryuken, and it's a little harder to pull that off. The Shoryuken does not have an option to follow up after it, though. So... Like that. This does, though. In the corner. How about JoJo Heritage for the Future characters? Yeah. No, it's supposed to be Street Fighter versus King of Fighters. It's just a fan game. This is Ken from Street Fighter, and that's Terry Bogard from King of Fighters, Fatal Fury, all manner of SNK. It's not original by any means. Yeah. So you can get 2 of these as well. Time right. Currently. What's that song? Take a guess. It's an Iori something. Oh! Oh shoot, I don't have my thing on. You're right. Okay, hold on. Hold on. You're right. I need my song thing. There you go. Should be up. There you go. I'm sorry, I forgot my song titles. It's funny because I was thinking about that just before I went live. I'm like, oh yeah, I gotta put those up. Oh, I never did. Yeah, I'm just not seeing... I'm seeing more problems with this move than not. But that's... I mean, that's what happens when you think about adding and changing moves. It's just kind of how it goes. This is the process that I go through for any move. So I just wanted to give you... thought it would be a good opportunity to give an insight into, like... Well, how does it... How do you develop the moves? How do you think about... the balance and... I figured this was a good opportunity while I had something in mind. I don't think it's gonna work out all right, though. I'm gonna do something JoJo-ish in Photoshop with your Game Jolt Guile Shadow. we'll go right ahead. It's actually, those portraits are from Match of the Millennium. It was on the Neo Geo Pocket Color, a very... kind of like the Game Boy Color for SNK's games. Yeah, yes, the music is sick. That's Iori's theme from one of the King of Fighters. It's the saxophone number 4. Not sure what game it came from. Oh, you know what? I think this is from KOF 13, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, I think I'm going to revert these changes. But it was fun to think about. To see what could be. Just don't see very much. It feels like a very inconsistent kind of move. And it feels like that its newfound purpose has already been done by other moves that give better consistent results so long as you can hit them. So I'm going to take that out. So we're going to remove the air juggle by copying the ground properties and pick out the tent turtle. I'm going to hop through some streams. Good luck with your game. Well, thank you very much. I hope to see you back sometime soon. We go every Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Happy to have you. Hope to see you again. Have a good one. Alright, I think we're going to get to pixel art now. Sad that that move didn't work out, but I go through that cycle all the time. 3 a.m. in the Netherlands right now. Hey, listen, we got other people from the Netherlands that are in here. Don't you slack out. We've got ones sticking it out in here. Tim, where are you? I saw you in there earlier.
Oh, hello.
What are you doing? What are you doing under my chair? Doggy's here. Hello. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to boot you with my foot. I didn't know you were there. Hello. What you doing? What you doing? Hey. What you doing?
Dog come.
Dog's coming to visit. Alright. So, let's pull up the old pixel art. Yeah, dog time. Maybe I should make the dog one of the emotes. I don't know if she. I don't know if she shows up enough to. I don't know. Every stream, she seems to pop up and get under the chair. I don't know. Dog time. Let's see. We were working with stages. Neo Geo World. Nighttime. And we were rebuilding it in... Where's Ace Sprite? There it is. Because Ace Sprite's better. Neo Geo World. Those are not the Ace Sprite files, though. So... Are they in here? Oh, that's just showing what's over there. Okie dokie, we're gonna have to find it. Oh, here's other recent folders. Stages. Well, I'm just going to stages. Normal stages. Let's see. Ninja World. And the nighttime. And there may or may not be an Ace Sprite file in here. Let's see. Sprite. Here we are. Okay. Once we can find it, next we do something with it. Alright, so the next task here is we're going to take the actual buildings out of the background. Finally find Stroheim pick. Oh, yeah. Stroheim from JoJo Part 2. Hope it's gonna fit in the shadow. that'll be funny. Let's see, this is the PNG, this is not the layered version. This is the layered version. And it's just a thing on top of there. So what ended up happening, I believe... Oh, here's the other layered file. What ended up happening... was we removed the water shadow. I don't know, do I have another layered one? Here's another one. Nope, that's just the whole thing. I'm trying to figure out now, what did I do? Did I just layer it on top? Alright, we're gonna have to actually pull this stage up and figure out what the heck did I do here. Oh yeah, that's exactly what I did. Okay, so I left it as one solid layer here. But what I did is I just pasted this sprite over the background. So frame one, frame two, and then it disappeared to reveal what was already there in frame three. That's not gonna work anymore. We gotta change that. We absolutely have to change that. Where you're here, I'm gonna pull upon your wisdom for a moment. When we were thinking that we want to separate these into different layers here and have them slide in, does that include the background here? The far background? Would that be attached also to the layer here? This portion. And I guess this portion would be the last. Or did you literally mean just do the bridge and then the far background would be its own thing still? It's getting more complicated by the second. My brain's going kind of 50-50 on it, being like, I don't know how much it would bring to... separate too much here, but might look cool. If you put parallax on the bridge, then you'd have to break it into a lot of slices. Uh-oh. How many slices are we talking? I was thinking 1, 2, 3. A lot. We thought about putting parallax on the bridge. We talked about it last time. A lot. So what do we want to do then? You saying like every segment here would probably have to be parallax? I could see that being the case. But then you're going to break like the wires here too. Maybe that won't be the smartest idea to do then. Yeah. So then we should rip it from the far background then, you think? Or no? No, okay. Yeah, that's what's running through my head too. I'm like, because then this would be shifting away from the back, and it's supposed to be connected to the back, right? So that would kind of break it. Okay, so this thing just as a whole will slide in and out from the side there. Probably just very slightly. It really makes me wonder. Just moving this bridge a little bit would be cool, but. And then you would expect this part to move, and this part to move, and then it's probably gonna look weird. Yeah. Alright, it stays away. Fine. Fine! Fine! Okay, so we've got this. We're gonna have to at least separate it from the sky drop. The good news is we don't need the monkey so much with the way that this works. We're gonna have to fill in the parts that will not or that will be seen here, because this is the bridge, and if the bridge is moving, get here. If this or not bridge, but the sidewalk railing is moving here, and it's going to reveal these gaps. So we do have to fill that in and figure out what to do there. Which is not going to be too hard because it's literally just filling in some lines. Now this and this are the pillar here, and then this little overhang. Underhang or whatever. So we're not worried about filling those gaps in. Those fill themselves in. It's really just this railing here with the little drop down bars. This part's easy because this is all just water with no shadow. And this should be easy enough to just squiggle in something real quick. So, what we want to do here is at least in this portion, yeah, we just want to do this. Oh, hell, actually. Yeah, for the inside here, yeah, I have to gate that off so it doesn't fill outside. Damn it! The inside here, we'll start with this. And let's do something. Mm-hmm. Ta-da! That's really all you need. Wrong color. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, look at that. There's a shadow. So what is going on over here? Oh, that's the break and the... This is still the railing here. So we'll block it off like this. Hello again! You're back! Yeah, so this just connects down into here. That's what that gap right here is for. So now all of the gaps are bridge pieces. And we want to just patch up the bottom here now again. Ah. That's interesting. There's this one here. Oh, you know what? What if it looks like that? Something like that. It should be fine. Okay, that's different. Alright, and then this should come down. Should come down all the way. It does not. It comes down a little bit. Notice that this doesn't come down all the way. There's actually one gap here. Don't know if that's what our layers are going to show or not. On the off chance that there is an issue here, we'll just fill it in. Actually, we can't do that. Oh my god, we can't do that. Because this has to show through. This is actually going to be on top of this. You need to be very careful about what gets filled and what doesn't. So, to err on the side of caution for now, I'm going to nuke that one there too. We're gonna copy this. That can't be right, can it? Oh yeah, it is. Huh. I didn't think it was that small. Now we're just gonna save this as an ASPRite file. So this will be Bridgewater. Neo Geo World. Oh, we spelled it out. Neo Geo World Night Bridgewater. You can't make the Photoshop thing? That's alright. I do that oftentimes too. I like, you know what? I'm gonna do this thing real quick, and then I get to it, and I'm like, this is gonna take hours. I just don't care that much. So I avoid it. You know, actually, what we could do here, because now it's an ASPRite file, watch this. We're gonna make, we're gonna add a frame here.
What are you growling at?
What are you doing?
What?
Are you growling? Or you just want attention? Somebody wants attention. Alright, come here.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come here. There you go. Come on. Here.
She wants up on the couch so she can be next to me. That's what it's for. That's what she's... She's just going, trying to get attention. Okay, so I can go to this, delete this one, paste it. Oh, what happened? What the hell happened? What did I do? What did I do? I hit something bad. I hit something bad. Oh no, what did I do? Patterned. Oh, here. Patterned? Paintbrush. I don't want that. What? Oh no, what did I do? What did I do? Back? Oh, here we go. I screwed some. I hit some kind of key. Okay. Paste. And put it down there. So now we've got this. And see, now it's animated. So all we want to do now is to take the canvas of the sprite and do it here so that we can see. Oh, there it is. I guess that one is. So here's the magic with this. We can take our cut up one here and actually layer it in so we can see the whole thing. I think that's the old file. The old file. Isn't it? It's the only layered one? No, that's a PNG. New version. No, that's still a PNG. I guess this really is the only one. Or is it this? Oh, here's a PSP image. Maybe this is the newest one. I don't even remember anymore. So, it's just one thing. Yeah, I guess because it was just attached right to it. So let's set that aside just for a moment. And I want to get this cleaned up and moved out of here. So we know that is where it's supposed to be. Here we are. So here's the 4. We want it under the 4. That didn't work. What happened? Did I screw something up? I probably screwed something up. I want a new layer. Come on. New layer. Now paste. Oh no. It's all screwed up. Yep, it's all screwed up. This is too high. What happened here? Needs to be down. Okay, we're gonna lock that one in place. Lock the background. Alright, layer 1 has nothing on it. Let's try this again. Oh, because we were in the sky. That's why I didn't pick up anything, right? Wheel 4. What layer is this? Oh my god. What layer are you? Back hole. Okay. That's why. I copied a layer of blank data. Alright, here we go. There we go. We're just going to use what's already there to align it so we know exactly where it's supposed to be. And then we're going to remove the visibility. Oh wait, we're going to say this is city. And we're going to remove this and this. And now we can just work on the city itself. Oh, I locked it. So cool. Alright. First order of business is to get rid of these parts of it that come from the fence and foreground. Just cut them out real quick. So we can cut all the way. The chat says, I think we really need a JoJo character in the next waves. At least Jotaro. Well, see, right now, the game is more of a Street Fighter versus King of Fighters affair. I wanted to keep it along those lines. The way that the stands work in Heritage to the Future, and the way that they're in a 3-button style game, I'm not sure would necessarily translate mechanically very well to what I have laid out in Pocket Fighter games. So if you haven't already, you can try the demo. You might see what I'm talking about. Where the game is more... It doesn't have, like, the opportunity to have, like, a stand button. So it uses, like, V-trigger kind of stuff, like FADC kind of mechanics from Street Fighter 4 and 5, and it has like an armor mode and the power max mode, which is the kind of sort of V-trigger thing. I'm not sure how I would translate that into allowing the stands to exist. I think it would be very difficult to make that work in a way that feels right. Because otherwise you're taking away the unique feeling of the JoJo characters, because their whole deal is the fact that they have stands. And then none of the other characters would have anything like that. Should make me be reluctant to add a special mechanic just for the JoJo characters to have a stand. I think it would be an overwhelming advantage. Partly because some of the advantages that the stands give you in Heritage to the Future, such as like increased defense, lowering chip damage while they're active and stuff, that's already handled by other mechanics, like the armor max. And I would be afraid that they would interfere in that way if I were to let them exist. I think if I were to put the JoJo's in a game, it would probably be something like Jump Superstars. Some kind of anime crossover fighter, something along those lines. TLDR, enemy stands are too strong. Kind of, like, the fact that in the JoJo games you can turn them on and off at will would be a huge advantage in Pocket Fighter EX. It would be a huge, huge advantage. One that I would have difficult rectifying for the rest of the cast. I don't think it would be mechanically sound to split up everything like that. Like, there is something to be said for having some characters that play different than others, of course. You know, you don't want your entire cast to be the same across the board. However, there has to be some sort of consistency between the way that they work, or it won't feel like a cohesive game. Because no one can deflect the Emerald Splash. Wouldn't that be wild if it was just some unblockable move? Oh, that'd be so busted. People would be so mad about that. It'd be funny, though. It would be really funny. But, you know, and I say all this as a pretty big JoJo fan. I think on some level I really would love to see it work like that, but I just can't imagine it fitting too well. Now, like I said, in some sort of like anime crossover fighter? Oh, I could see that fit real well. It would be a very unique set of characters to use in that kind of environment. But you have like crazier things going on in those kind of games. You can get away with that because everybody's got some crazy BS. So it looks like the skyline just kind of creeps up on here. And it cuts flat here. And I'm okay with that. So I think what I'm going to do is just cut out this portion. And that will be the hard skyline portion here. There's no texture to the sky. It just happens to be melded in with the rest of the architecture here. So there's not too much of a problem just doing this. But I do want to remove the texturing from here, because as the layer scrolls in and out, you will get some movement here. And if the texture just stops dead cold, what you'll end up with, let's see, was that the right one to take out? Yeah, what you'll end up with, and I can show it right here, No good. Where is... Do we have a sky? Oh, we do here. Okay, we'll just do this. I can get the right key here. Oh. So see how this shimmers here? Like this? Because the pattern doesn't match. That's what you'd have if it wasn't removed. Either would happen here or wherever you cold cut the pattern. So you don't want that shimmering to occur, so I have to erase all of that in there. And you'll get a slight shimmering on the pixels on the end here, but that's alright. And they're just lights in the background, so to be completely honest, them having a little shimmer effect is not the end of the world, and it might actually look kind of neat. So we're gonna leave that there, and then it will cold cut at this point. So there will be no shimmer on this dot because it will cut the pattern here. And that's all right, too. I think that'll look fine. Okay, so we've got a little bit of reconstruction to do here. Perhaps. Maybe not. That background... Oh, the sky layer is a different... We're going to have to add a sky layer here. So let's... Sky. we can just kind of copy this. So here's the trick with the sky. We're not going to actually save it in this style. It's going to be a very small texture, and we're going to repeat it. We're going to loop it and pile it across the back. And Unity lets you do that. I'll show that when we get to it. But we don't need to do much with this here. So the sky is going to be lined up here. Yeah, and you'll be able to see now that I put this in. See that little shimmering? It's not bad. And then you don't see the shimmer so much here. Nothing to bounce off of it. But we need... Let's see. From here, how many ticks does it take to reveal the top? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5. We have to cut 5 off the top. Actually, the easier way to do this would be cut more. To be honest, this is probably the easier way to do it. We'll align it where we need it, which would be here. We'll copy it to the end. So we'll have to copy a little off. It's one pixel on the pattern off. Make sure we didn't break the pattern. And then what you can do is just select from the top and fill in using the colored sky. There you go. So you're all set then. In fact, what I'm going to do, I'm going to extend it even further so that we have it just all the way across the back. That way we don't have a gap up here. We won't see that gap in game. You'll see how it works. And I miscalculated one last time. But that's fine. We'll patch it here. Okay. And then you see the skyline across the whole thing. If you really want to like simulate it moving, you can just do that. Did I do it right? Yeah, okay. I think we're all set. I think I got it right. I just moved it up. When I was moving it left to right, I moved it up too much down. Looked like I misaligned it. I think we're okay. Now we can turn the background back on and we get the ocean. And we turn the building back on and the floor and voila, here we go. I'd like Lucky Land Communications to make some new game with Capcom. Oh, wouldn't that be great? Can you imagine? Well, okay, but let me dial that back a little bit. If you could get the original team from Heritage to the Future, which they no longer work at Capcom, they've already moved on. You could get them with the same attention to detail and the same budget to work on something new. Yes, I would love that. Capcom's current fighting game division and the amount of resources they actually give them right now? I don't know. I guess I wouldn't scoff at it, but I'm not sure what I would expect out of it. I think I'd be happy at start, but I'd be kind of wary after a while. I'd be like, wait, how good is this really going to turn out now that all their good fighting game staff is left? You know what I mean? Okay, so here we've got to make a decision on what to do. The main problem here is we have our border. It's easier to see on other stages, but you should be able to see the color disparity on stream here. And then you can see that we've got a gap. And the reason this gap exists is because when the screen is normally at the end, this is what you see. But if screen shake occurs, it reveals up to 4 pixels of additional stage material. And this shouldn't be too bad. You don't usually see this anyway. So if you just kind of phone in the end here, no one's gonna notice. I hate to be like that, but That's the truth. No one's gonna notice. Because they're barely ever gonna see this. So you just do this and you're done. You have a nice day. You're all good. Should we spill over? Good. And to be honest, the shapes here are not all that complicated. So this really isn't too bad here. Most of this is just gonna be dark anyway. The really only part here to think about is just having this dot. But that's it, and then just fill around it. You know, this is an easy one to extend. I could have just as easily moved it 4 pixels off to the right, but I like the indent texture. 2 out of 10, far right pixel on a Neo Geo stage was off. IGN. Well, I'll be quite frank, I don't really care what IGN would ever think about any of my games. I'm sure you can surmise why. I'm not worried about them. Their opinion is, well, it's interesting. Nothing to be regarded. In fact, I'm really surprised that IGN is still around. They must have some parent company that's keeping them afloat. With all the problems that ad revenue is bringing to news sites, like, IGN just never felt like they downsized all that much. Since they kind of, like, faded out of the limelight. And then it's just, like, at this point, like, where's all their money coming from to keep them afloat? Which is fine. I mean, they have a right to exist like any other company. If they can stay afloat, by all means. I'm not saying they should go under. I'm just surprised that they haven't. And it's fine. They can sit there for all eternity if they want. I'm just a little surprised by it. Now I'm on the shit list. Any game I ever make that's just gonna give me a fucking 2 out of 10. Oh well, whatever. Who listens to games media anymore? Okay, I'm trying to learn my keyboard shortcuts here. They are very different between the two programs, between PaintShop Pro and this. Okay, that looks alright. I think we'll be okay with this. So if we take out the back background, then we've got the Nope, we still got. And this is why I disable these layers every now and then. To catch these. Do the brush. Catch these little gaps. Yeah. Save that. And then these are animated elements. The tops of the things glow here, and this glows. There might be another one here or there. I've got those as separate entities already sorted out. Getting a whole bunch of messages on Discord. What's going on? Getting tagged. Ah, they're calling me a boomer. They're calling me a boomer at Discord. They had a whole boomer discussion a little earlier. Today. Screw it, whatever. I'm old enough. Throw your stones. I don't care. Okay. Yeah, we'll leave that on. So the skyline's here. In reality, we're just gonna put a polygon in the background that has a solid color on it. And then this pattern is what I meant earlier, is that it's going to be this size, and it will just repeat this pattern to the right and left. And it'll just be a giant bar of it in the background. You'll see when we put it in. Okay, so now that we have that out of the way, what I wanted to do is to take the third layer of waves here, and we're going to put it into here. So we need to make one more frame. Get rid of it. Put the onion skin on so we can see the overlay of the layer here. And I'm just gonna grab the whole dang thing. Looks like it lines up essentially here. Yeah, no, it's not right. Is that right? No, it's not. Doop. Oh, there we go. Now it's all right. Yeah, there we go. See? Okay, so we want to just block out. And this is pretty easy, actually. I'm just gonna trace the lines here to create this cutout shape. And then we will go... Oh! Shoot, how do I... The control? How do I get... There's Alt. Nope. Maybe it's Control. No, 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 it's not Control. Okay. I have selected here, but I wanna subtract from selection, so that's Alt Shift. Okay, got it. Okay. Yeah. So I didn't select enough then, I guess. Wait, what am I doing now? Added selection. Subtract from selection, right? This whole thing. Oh no. I screwed it up. Now I don't know what's in or out. This is inside the selection. And this is outside. So yeah, I need to subtract, right? Subtract from selection. Here. Oh, there it goes. I think it's because I was holding shift. Oh yeah. When I was holding shift, it was actually changing the mode. Okay, we're good. So now I would just go to the third one, and now that it's selected, I can hit delete. Retrace it all. Yeah. Game dev boomers. Well, you know, it's not quite that inaccurate. It really isn't. So we can make another layer. Let's delete that. I'm surprised the selection didn't stay, though. Because I wanted to also... We could use magic wand for this. I don't know. Magic wand. Boom. And... Boom. So... Oh, interesting. Oh, no, it's because onion skin was on. I was going to say, why is this semi-transparent? It's just the onion skin. It also proves that I can fill that in as well, so let's do that. There. Now there's no gap. There's our water. So, what I wanted to do is this waves and the new layer, which is going to get moved down. It's gonna be say border. I could just call it black. Cause it is just a black background. So this has to be all the same. This is link, right? Yeah, link cells. There. And now we've got the background. But if we ever want to save it without it, it's easier to edit with it, but if we want to save it without it, then we can just hide it. And we'll lock that. And now we can export the frames as individual things. One thing that's caught my attention is that this element here doesn't change. And should I make that like this cutout? Might help us align it. Wait, one of Terry's special moves is uppercut with Shoryuken buttons. The only time he ever had a Shoryuken input with in the King of Fighters games, let me specify, in the King of Fighters games, as far as I'm aware, the only time he's ever had a Shoryuken input with a punch button, a forward Shoryuken input, so that's forward, down, down forward, and a punch was in 98, maybe 2002 UM, and it was some kind of like energy punch overhead thing. I did not add that into Pocket Fighter EX, but that is the only time that that's been a thing. So I'm thinking we cut this out. It doesn't change. It doesn't mean anything. Undo that. I think I cut from the wrong layer. I gotta cut from this layer. Yeah. And then we'll know not to intrude on that. And that makes more sense. You could argue that we could cut this off too. But it just kind of blends in with the... Now my OCD is getting to me. We'll cut it out. Nope. Gotta cut one more. There. Now it's just the wings. And we can optimize this actually a little bit. We can bring this in. Oh, and that is our time's up marker. Have to start wrapping up now. We can cut here because nothing ever goes past this. You know, oh, I guess I can't skip through. I can't skip through the frames with the arrow keys when you do that. But notice that nothing ever goes past this point where you've got wave up in the top left that actually moves. So, I'm surprised the onion skin doesn't take effect here for the gap. And then we can bring this in. The less pixels it has to draw, the better. It'll be the faster that it goes. Now you could get even crazier with this and split these up into separate files. Since we're doing 2D pixel art, it's really not all that pertinent, but because it helps you align it and all that. So I'm not too worried about that. If they were just dead space, then I would cut it. I think we've got all that out of the way. So the other thing I wanted to do then, because of all that, is now we want to cut that from here because it is no longer needed. In fact, we will fill this in with a color. It just won't be needed here. It's really just gonna look like that, Remember, we kept this shape cut out too. And to do a test, we will copy one of these layers in and make a new layer, and we're gonna say test city waves. And look at that. Now we're just gonna align it to where this needs to go. And we do see a problem already. One that's not lined up here. I guess it's supposed to be. I don't know. Now I'm really curious. How does. Oh, you know what? We've got an alignment over here. So we can figure it out. Guess it goes this high. Might go up to here. Yeah, I guess that makes sense because now this is flush with this. No, it's not. No, it's got to go down one. Yeah, here. Okay, so there was a gap left by removing those lines. So I will back to the city and add that. Let's look at our original. How was this? Okay, so there was a blank column on the right side. That's what was throwing me off here. So this is supposed to be blank here. And this. I guess there was no. Nope, there was no blank column. The waves just go right through. Okay. That works. So if we turn this off, we can see that it doesn't interfere with anything. Right in the place. Cool. So if I turn the test water off, yeah, and then the city's got a full blue under it. And if we turn the floor on, then we get this. So if we see, it's gonna move a little bit in and out as we go back and forth. With the parallax. Then. Yeah, that's pretty good for now. So I think that's where we're gonna have to end it. We're getting there, we're filling it in. And the advantage here of having this now in its own animation file, one, that we can see the animation and edit it as an animation. But if we go ahead and say export sprite sheet as a vertical strip, see what it's doing? We'll be able to output that. What's constraints? I guess there's nothing there. Oh yeah, that's the preview. Yeah, to show you. So the advantage here. And we'll use this to view it easier. See, now we have a sprite sheet here. And they're all separated and they have their transparent background. You don't need to do that necessarily. I think you can select a background color in Unity to not show through. Maybe. Well, you know what? It has to be not an anime GIF, but it has to be a GIF or a GIF. This is the way you're supposed to say it. But that border color needs to be a transparent. Like, it needs to be set as transparent in the GIF file. I'm not sure how to do that on here, so we'll just leave this the way it is. And let's see. Create palette from current sprite. How about we do that? Oh, let's do that again. There, now I have the black. Let's save. Okay, And that's pretty much it. One of these is going to have to be the transparent, but I'm not sure how it manages that. I'll have to look that up. So yeah, that's pretty much it for now. So, we'll be back on Monday, the... Oh my god. It's going to be June? It should be June 1st. We'll be back Monday, June 1st at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for more Pocket Fighter EX stuff. So we'll get to actually putting the animations in. You'll get to see that. And putting the parallax on the city scape. And whatever else we end up getting to. We'll probably be putting in the water shimmering, which you don't see here, but we did the moon shimmering. But we have, well, those are tower lights, broken lights. Now where is it? Power lights here. Moon water, moon. I don't see water reflection here. There. I guess I just did them all as one big sprite. And so this turns on and off. It flickers on and off into the stage. Oh, you can see it right here. Where they're flickering. So it's doing a little more than that. It's checkerboarding it too, but we'll get into that later. That's a whole other thing. I might change the way that works anyway. But, well, that's a whole topic to unpack later. So, yeah, that's where we are. And on Sunday, we'll have another gameplay stream with me and Amber. We heard earlier, if you were here, explaining the gore and gourd. And we'll be playing a game together on Sunday. And that'll be at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So we do kind of a Sunday-Monday back-to-back. And then if you are hanging around during the week, here's our Discord link in the chat. Or if you're if you're watching this on Library or YouTube after the fact, the link will be down below for that. And so we are a patron-funded stream, and I've got some names to read out. Who we got? Zombie Killer, we've got Miguel Tabasco, AJ, Anthony Moniz, Bryce Nagoinum, Corporal Chungus, D-Money107, Larry, or LD Walker, Mike Cruz, Uncle Roy, thank you Uncle Roy, thank you for supporting your family, Rui Luis, and Darren Williams, so thank you very much, you guys stuck through thick and thin. If you want to be part of the Scrub Army, you can get advanced builds of the projects I work on, including this one. You can get code samples, a bunch of other stuff. So check that out. Links down below for that on the Patreon. And that's pretty much it for me. I'll see you guys hopefully Sunday and Monday. And that's it. So have a good one. Scrub out.